It's a wild, wild, wild kingdom presents Otters, court jesters of the sea. This week on It's a Wild, Wild, Wild Kingdom, we'll be visiting with our friends, the sea otter. The sea otter is a mammal. It lives along the coast of the central and northern Pacific Ocean. Here we see one in its own natural environment, undisturbed by man. The sea otter is the smallest marine animal in North America at only 4 feet long. Good. Love the lens. Good. The female weighs an average of 45 pounds, and the male, an average of 65 pounds. And they wear a size 6X. As for their lifespan, these adorable little creatures live an average of only 10 years. You're sad now. Show me sad. Good. Otters have great personalities and are among the most playful animals in the sea. I said they're among the most playful animals in the sea. The coastal waters the sea otters live in are extremely cold, ranging from a chilly 50 degrees to a downright freezing 30 degrees. Unlike other marine mammals, sea otters don't have blubber to keep them warm. But they do have other ways to keep warm, namely their thick fur and high body temperature. In order to maintain their high body temperature, they must eat the equivalent of 20 to 25% of their body weight every day. That would be like a human having to eat 100 hamburgers a day. Fortunately for them, sea otters like seafood. Among their favorites are clams, crabs, escargot, and starfish. And they dine floating on their backs, using their stomachs as a table. To help them crack open their shellfish, sea otters often use tools. And luckily for us, we've happened across one doing just that. Here's one diving for food. Let's follow along.
Jim.
Yes?
You don't have to do that now. We can just record you saying that later.
Okay.
Nature has equipped the sea otter with little pouches under their armpits where they can store food and tools while they're swimming. Otters, court jesters of the sea, will return after these messages.
Now available on videotape from It's a Wild, Wild, Wild Kingdom. They bite, they scratch, they foam at the mouth. It's when cartoon animals attack. See a duck with a mallet attack a defenseless birdwatcher. Bear witness to this terrifying, unprovoked grizzly attack. Look on in horror as this kangaroo pummels an unsuspecting tourist. And if you call now, you'll receive as a free gift when nocturnal cartoon animals attack. What the? No,
Now, back to our program. As we mentioned earlier, the sea otter has extremely thick fur. In fact, it has the thickest fur of any animal. It has as many as 600,000 to a million hairs per square inch. No, not that type of hair. Sorry.
Okay, hairs, you can leave now. And you can collect your $10 at the door.
Where was I? Oh, yeah. The natural oils in its thick fur.
Wait, I have the thickest fur.
Well, sir, take off your sweater and let's take a look.
I'm not wearing a sweater.
As I was saying, the natural oils in the sea otter's fur repels water and traps air bubbles, providing a layer of warm air between the otter's skin and the cold water. It's for this reason that it's important sea otters remain well-groomed, and why they spend up to 6 hours a day caring for their fur. The sea otter grooms itself by rubbing its fur with its forepaws, then blowing warm air into its fur and combing it with its claws. They then roll and twirl in the water to smooth their fur. Remaining clean and well-groomed is important to an otter. Because if its fur becomes dirty and matted, there's no room for the warm, bubbly air layer. And when this happens, the otter will freeze to death. For hundreds of years, the southern sea otter was hunted for its warm, thick fur, and there are now only a few thousand left. But thankfully, the sea otter has become a protected species, so it's illegal to harm them. Due to this recent effort, the sea otter population has begun to rebuild itself. But by no means does this mean they are home free. Oil spills still pose a major threat to the sea otter population, but people are now being trained how to best help the sea otter if such a tragedy should occur.
Ratten! Down the hatches!
Well, the time has come to leave our furry, fun-loving friends. Until next time, toodaloo! Or as the sea otter would say,